We're here with the Ford Mustang Boss 302. Now for years, Ford's been making some very powerful V8 engines in the GT and the Shelby. The problem is they had a lot of power, but you couldn't really harness that power, especially if you wanted to take it out here on the track. So what we have here is essentially a track version of the Ford GT, known as the Boss 302. One of the key differences in the Boss 302 is that it has shorter intake runners. That allows for the extra horsepower, 444 versus 420 in the stock Mustang GT. Another key differentiator are the badges. You have Boss 302 badges. Now these wheels, these tires are 19-inch summer compound tires, so they help you keep this car on the track. On the inside, you get factory installed Recaro seats with Alcantara inserts. You also have an Alcantara steering wheel and headliner. So if all those visual cues aren't enough for you, all you have to do is start this thing up and you hear the sport exhaust right away. And this thing is throaty. One of the challenges with vehicles like the Boss 302 that are really designed for the track is that the suspension kind of beats you up on your day-to-day driving. Well, this Boss 302 has an adjustable suspension, so when you're commuting to work, no problem. It's a little more comfortable, a little more livable. When you need it on the track, you can stiffen it up so you can handle all those turns and have a lot of fun doing it. So there you have it. If you are planning to take your Mustang GT on the track, I would recommend spending the extra money. This car goes between $42,000 to $45,000. Step up to the Boss 302, so when you go out here, you're going to be able to keep things under control and have a lot of fun in your daily driving.